YouTube, what's up? We are in the emergency room. Guess what? Today is an emergency. Actually, yesterday was and still today. So everyone is waking up to the new update. And I'm here today to talk to you about this specific update and how to play in it. It is really not that hard. All right. Just, if you're here for the second time, you know, subscribe, like the video, do the thing. And please let me know about your strats or potential strats in the comments. Okay, so this was the update from yesterday, June the 2nd, and this is the balance changes on the berries, so only berries, right? We are not changing tokens, we are not changing anything, we are just changing the berries. So all berries now are actually specifically Lum, Lepa, Citrus, and Enigma are gonna go down to 2 maximum, and all other ones are gonna be down to 3, so from 10, by the way. And the berry pouches are going to be changed from 33% per stack to 100%, down to 30% chance to the new cap, 90%, which means you are actually losing berries now. It is still pretty rare to lose them, but it is going to be the case, especially for those here, the Lum berries. And this is why I am making this video today. Just to explain to you how we are gonna play. So keep that in mind, we do have the Toxic Orb now. And the Toxic Orb is gonna be a ultra tier item, which is the yellow one. Okay, so let's talk about all the different strats and how to deal with them with the new changes of the berries. It is gonna be pretty tedious, so be ready. There is definitely a new meta and there is a meta that's going out, for sure. It is still doable. So I'm gonna explain how to play the new how to play Endless now with Sturdy only. So no immunity to status condition. I mean, you do need Kanda. But those are all tedious and you cannot play Nightshade and Seismic Toss anymore. So there you go. Those are going to be the first three. So Metal Burst, Dots and Nightshade, Seismic Toss, I explained those in my Endless video, team building guide. So you need to watch this if you don't know. But I'm talking about adjusting to the new meta right now. So you need, if you didn't watch it, you need to watch my team building guide. And then maybe come back here. Or, you know, just being aware of what's going to be played. But basically, Metal Burst, you play with Metal Burst, Protect, Roar, and maybe Misty Terrain or some kind of dots. And for dots, you play Curse Soak, Salcure, Leech Seed, Protect, and Super Fang, or any kind of half move like Nature's Madness or Ruination. But you want to have Curse and Soak on your support anyways. But your main daughter is going to have Salcure, Leech Seed, Protect, Nature's Madness, or Super Fang. So this is Dots. And for Nightshade and Seismic Toss, this is just basically playing Nightshade and Seismic Toss plus Protect. That's it. And then you count on berries. But that's the problem here, right? We need to use berries. And berries are actually nerfed, like I said earlier. So how do you play now? Now, this is not something I would say to play at all on a new run, but if it is your current run and you are like at 4k or 3.5k or 5k and you want to end, this is how you do it. So now you need to have an immunity to status condition and you probably need a pickup Pokemon. Okay, so for the new strat or like update your team, I guess you would need to have Misty Terrain or Misty Surge. So you need to add Misty Terrain to your support or your main Pokemon, to be honest, doesn't matter. And then you need to like use Misty Terrain all the time, right? So you need to unsplice one of your Pokemon and add Misty Terrain in. This is very important here. Misty Terrain is basically gonna immune you to status condition for 5 turns, and then 5 turns should be enough to kill any Pokemons later on, like any big fights. The thing is, you can't really fight in between, or if you do, you need to take only the single battles, right? With like no boss Pokemons, just to get berries back, right? But let me explain. So you need to play Misty Terrain, or you need to play Misty Surge, like a Pokemon that gets Misty Terrain whenever it gets in the battle. So you need to have Galar Weezing or Tapu Fini with Misty Surge, okay? This is the first step. Second step, you need to have a pickup Pokemon again, I believe. So what you do is you put all the berries on the pickup Pokemon, all of them, okay? And then you are just gonna let space for 3 berries, Lum, Citrus, Enigma. You still need to have some Lum berries because you're not going to be immune all the time. You still have this this space where you don't have any Misty Terrain. But yeah, so leave a space for Lum, Citrus, and Enigma. Those are the only berries you need. You don't need to have the rest of them. So what you do is you put Lum, Citrus, Enigma on all your Pokémon. When you don't need them on your main Pokémon, just put them on all of them. This way, whenever you run your main Pokémon actually runs out, you can switch them from the other Pokémon or from your pickup Pokémon to your main. Okay, so make sure to have a stock of Lum, Enigma, and Citrus on all your Pokémon and never remove the other berries from your pickup Pokémon. Okay, so this way, we only have a slot for Lum, Enigma, and Citrus. And so you need to take fights in between the Paradox Pokémon so you can maybe put Misty on Misty Terrain and then kill some Pokémon, some wild Pokémon easy to kill and just add more berries into your stack. But it's not that bad. It's still 90% chance of not losing the berry, so you're not going to lose them all the time. But if you play only Sturdy without immunity, you are going to lose all your berries very fast. Okay, so you need some kind of immunity and you need a pickup Pokémon. I'm sorry to say, but this is how it is, right? If you try to blast through, you are going to lose all your berries and you are going to lose your run. You need to have immunity and you need to have a pickup Pokémon to get a refill, quote-unquote, of those berries. So this is the first way to go. Do not play Nightshade Seismitos with Sturdy only. You can't do it. Dots and Embers are still doable, to be honest, if you play with some immunity. But otherwise, if you start a new run, do not start with only Sturdy. Play with those strats at the bottom. But I will explain. I'm only going to explain Poison Heal actually because the other ones I have already explained. And there is a Google document for this, for the Sheninja strat. I will link it in the description. And if I don't have the link, just let me know in the comments. I can add it later on. All right, so let's talk about Purifying Salt. So this is a strat I was talking about in my team building video. Nightshade is always going to be lower. I think, to be honest, it's still a no because you still need access to Sturdy and you do kill pretty slow. It's like 2 or 3 hits. So I guess it's okay, but it's definitely not at the level of Dots or Metal Burst, for sure. Purifying Salt, what it does, or it can be Purifying Salt or Good as Gold, it doesn't matter. I have explained, but Purifying Salt is going to immune you to status condition, so you're never going to get any of them. Right, but you still rely on berries and you rely specifically on Citrus. Enigma as well, kinda, but mainly Citrus. So it's the same gameplay as this one here, but you do not need the Misty Terrain, but you do need the pickup Pokémon. So just leave a slot for Enigma and Citrus, right? Put them on all your Pokémon and then just switch the Citrus and the Enigma whenever you need it. Again, same gameplay as the three before here, but there is you are removing one step, and you don't need Lum berries as well. So it's way easier than this strat here. Now let's talk about Sheninja. Obviously, Sheninja is still fine. You can still play those two strats. They are still gonna destroy the game. Playing Sheninja with Dots, for example, it is very very strong. And finally, we have the new meta. So Nightshade is still bad, don't get me wrong, but Poison Heal is just broken. So I would say it is more gonna be tedious here for Sturdy and Nightshade. Nightshade and Seismitos, sorry. And with Poison Heal, it's gonna be okay. And of course, we have the new meta here. So, how do you play this? I haven't explained it on my team building guide, so I'm gonna explain. We do have the Poison Orb, and what the Poison Orb does is, at the end of the turn, the Toxic Orb badly poisons its holder. You want to play with Poison Heal and Poison Orb. So you pick up Poison Orb on your main Pokémon and you pick up Poison Heal or Sturdy. So this is gonna be for new runs or existing runs if you play Sturdy passive. So you can switch from Sturdy passive Purifying Salt to Sturdy passive Poison Heal if you are playing Sturdy as a passive ability. Okay? So this is how it works. Let me explain. Poison Heal, basically what it does, restores HP if the Pokémon is poisoned instead of losing HP. So what this does, it's gonna heal you back to full with all the healing charm and the poison orb. With the poison heal, it's always gonna get you back to full. So it does work with Sturdy, still. Then we have Sturdy. Of course, Sturdy, it is what it is, you know what it is. If you start a new run, You can go either Poison Heal passive into Sturdy or Sturdy into Poison Heal. You check Poison Heal, who has Poison Heal. So as a passive ability, only Paras and Parasect has it, so you need to start with Paras if you're gonna go that route. It is okay, they all have the same HP, so it doesn't matter that much. So if you start with Poison Heal, you want to merge into... So it's the same strat, you merge into Metal Burst. So you're looking for a Pokémon that has Metal Burst and has Sturdy as an ability. So it's gonna be most of the time Aggron, right? So you want to merge into Aggron. I would say it's the best one. If I had to say, oh, Arcaludon, it doesn't matter. But of course, you can do it three ways. You can teach Metal Burst to another Pokémon and then merge Unsplice and then merge into it. But if you don't want to have that extra step, like I said in the team building video, you want to go into Aggron or Arcaludon. So the setup would be Parasect into Aggron, because Aggron has Metal Burst, Roar, Protect, and all that jazz. Or you can start with Sturdy. Of course, it is a way to go. I would say it's probably the same thing. You can play Wormadam with Sturdy, because Wormadam Trash has Metal Burst by default. Or you can play Blastoise, because or Diglett, whatever, right? But probably Blastoise. If you want to play something different than Wormadam, you want to play Blastoise, because it has Sturdy and more HP. The only issue with playing Blastoise is that you do not get Metal Burst, so you need to find a Pokémon with it, right? And then you need to teach Metal Burst to your other Pokémon. So if you play Sturdy passive, you want to splice into Poison Heal, of course. So there is only three Pokémon, actually two, Breloom and Gliscor. Gliscor is going to be hard to find, not that hard to be honest, but it's just a very rare Pokémon overall, and it is the hidden ability as well, so it is pretty rare. Most of the time, you're gonna merge into Breloom, and Breloom can be found very easily, okay? You probably find so many Brelooms. You need to find a Pokémon with Poison Heal, or you can start with it, right? You can start with a Breloom in your team. I wouldn't say no, because you probably need better, but if you have a shiny Breloom, I do have a shiny Breloom, so I can potentially start with Breloom in my team. So you merge Sturdy into Poison Heal or Poison Heal into Sturdy, it doesn't matter. It is the same moveset, okay? The only thing that changes is gonna be the ability and how you merge into it. And the Pokémon that you are using. That is it. You still need 200k, 250k minimum for Metal Burst. You still play dots like you want. You just apply dots with your support and on your main and you spam Super Fang. It is the same gameplay. It's just that Poison Heal do not rely on berries. So not only you're going to be poisoned all the time, so you're going to be immune to status condition, but you're going to heal back to full health all the time. So there you go. That's the meta. So what you can do, I'm going to put this image in the description and you can share it to people that are asking questions and link them this video. I think this is a bad change overall. We didn't get the change of the tokens or the endless change or the endless rework with the berry change. So we are in a time right now where it is pretty bad to play endless if you don't play Poison Heal or Sheninja, but it is still playable, okay? It's just that those builds here are basically dead. As you can finish your run with it, you have a lot more micromanagement. It is still doable though, okay? So good luck, I would say. But if you start a new run, do not play Sturdy only. Play Purifying Salt passive or Sturdy passive and merge into either Purifying Salt or Poison Heal. Poison Heal is the best choice, of course. So there you go. I'm gonna download this image, I'm gonna save it, put it in the description, and you guys let me know, okay? So again, I hope you are gonna have a good day. Please subscribe to the channel if it's your second time coming here. Please like the video and share it to people as well if they have some questions. If I forget any link in the description, please let me know and I will add it. So that's gonna be it for me. Thank you guys for watching and I will see you in the next one. Bye.